Hello, welcome back to the Future of Data Platforms Summit. In this episode, I'm joined by Joe Steinke, who's the Senior Director of Data Management for the National Football League. Maybe you've heard of them before, but hey, welcome on, Joe.
Good to speak with you, Rob. Excited to cover this with you.
Yeah, I think this is near and dear to both our hearts, the topic of data management and data platforms and where it's going in the future. I think help people understand a little bit about your role with the NFL, and so they get a better idea of the scope.
Yeah, certainly. So I work within the data and analytics department and report into Paul Belews, our chief data and analytics officer. And my job is to lead the data management team. And the way we approach that is we really break it down into five main pillars with our resourcing. At the top is data governance, very critical, especially as we're looking at modernization and supporting the future of the platform. Then we go into our actual data engineering and architecture team. From there, we do have a carve-out dedicated to data solutions, so solutions architects that we can kind of deploy against some of our more critical integrations or most complex integrations to really drive that back into the engineering group. And then, of course, data operations. So that's where we have our 24/7 support and making sure we're meeting all our SLAs and taking stock of all the opportunities that exist within the ecosystem that we operate in. And then the final pillar is really what we dedicate to the end-to-end delivery. So we call it our analytics enablement function. This is where we have what we call data product owners dedicated to making sure we're interfacing properly with our stakeholders and our partners and leading the charge on requirement gathering with a body of analysts. And then we also roll our BI team into this analytics enablement group. So that's the function that I run. And then, of course, we partner with various bodies, whether it's our ecosystem team driving the underlying cloud platform and some of the foundational elements of our ecosystem, and then our analytics partners within the DNA group.
Yeah, I think that to me you have some really interesting things, and I love how you have it broken down there organizationally, because especially with the data product owners, which I'm a big fan of, again, basically being, like you said, the voice into the group from the business and helping, like you said, define the requirements and, translate them. When we talked, previously, we talked about the data platform and management journey that you and the NFL have been on over the past few years. Why don't you kind of give people kind of a flavor for that?
Yeah. So it's been a really exciting few years. We got direction and commitment to really dive all the way into building out this central data and analytics function. And at the heart of that was really the data ecosystem. So making sure that we could take it to the next level and modernize our approach to producing data products at scale and living up to the idea that we can cover all business domains throughout the organization. And really prior to that, obviously there was a ton of really sophisticated data processing and all this work going on. But like with most organizations, it was done in silos and all over, to solve very specific needs. And it wasn't always being done in a consistent fashion because it was really focused on those needs. So the idea that we could bring a central function in that could produce some standards and operational consistency throughout the league, is really what drove our decision to step back and create this ecosystem.
And you kind of mentioned it already, but like when you started out, you had these data silos. I'm sure that data products sometimes were, some of the data was in one part in one silo and some was in another silo. How did you get started? Because I think that's, it's analysis paralysis a lot of times for organizations.
Yeah, for sure. And then the added element there is that once we really got tasked with centralizing everything, it was all right, start running at 100 miles an hour. So it was very accelerated at the outset, but we stepped back and at the core of it was understanding those pillars that we walked through, and those have evolved since we first started, but really understanding what people do we need in the right roles, what skill sets do we need to make this work. And that was really at the core of it. And then from there, it's about putting the technical building blocks in place. So starting to assess what's going to work, what isn't. And that all came back to really centering on our core principles of building it in a repeatable, scalable, and well-governed way that will withstand the test of time, ideally, because we wanted to do it in a modular and interoperable way. So we dove right in to design the key elements of the architecture, and just started building and got those different pillars in line to dedicate to this kind of initial build out, but then beyond that, making sure that we could sustain long term on an operational sense.
Yeah, I was going to say that, because I think, again, it's once you get buy-in and you show results, it's probably easier then to get the next set or next team or next division or group on board. And is that kind of how it rolled? And is, you know, where are you now in your entire journey, do you think?
Yeah, and that's a good point. We, in this process, we made the determination that it'd be most suitable to build against very precise use cases and do it in a way, of course, that's going to scale out to other business domains. But we looked for our most, the business domains that would benefit most from being able to operate at scale, and chose those use cases and built around them, but always keeping those other domains in mind. So on the journey, we're entering our first season where we're leveraging this ecosystem in a production environment. So it's a really exciting time. And it's been a blur in a lot of ways these last couple of years to really meet our goal. And basically, we liken it to building the plane mid-flight. So on a process standpoint, how we got here, we stepped back and again, defined those key guiding principles. And what that boiled down to on kind of a more tactical sense is making sure that at the front door, we were applying data quality and governance controls, and really taking that to the next level, taking advantage of the opportunity of really starting fresh in a lot of ways. It's so hard to go back and apply those principles to legacy systems, but this was a great opportunity. Kind of in that same vein, we took and applied the principles of everything being automated as much as possible. So making sure that every cloud pipeline for resourcing or every data pipeline is being deployed through automation, and there's a lot less opportunity for manual intervention and error. And that extended into every one of our key design principles. And then looking at the data flow, it was all about standardizing the process to really shorten that window and length or time to market, and make sure that we can meet our needs and put all the processes in place to do that in the most effective and streamlined manner, so we're not circling back and gathering requirements over and over again. So that was really the goal in how we accomplished it in such a short span.
I would assume that, and again, this is a little bit deeper into that, because I think when you start working with the different application folks that are building applications on top of the data products, there you have to kind of, you know, almost have some, I think what you would say is get to that metadata layer, that's kind of that standardization of the models of what means what and the definition. How did you partner with the different parts of the organization to kind of, you know, get to that standardization? Because to me, that's one of the things that, you know, up above, you know, the gear and the cloud and the pipelines is, yeah, well, I need to get to my bronze, silver, gold medallion types of data. How do I know what the definition of revenue is here? Is it the same as it is over here kind of thing? And how did you work with the different application groups on that?
Yeah, it that was one of our biggest opportunities coming into this, and back to really applying that kind of governance and observability and metadata layer at the outset was new to a lot of the different domains that we started operating in. So it's a continual journey. It's not easy to make sure you're doing it all right, but the way we've approached it is to just really center with our stakeholders on their biggest needs and try to take that into account as we're going, put more emphasis into building models that are fit for consumption, so we know there's not seven different places to go for the same value, that it's really all channeling through a known pathway. And then just really looking at different applications to use for metadata management and data dictionaries and serve that up in a meaningful and fit for purpose way. And that extended not only to our downstream consumers, but in partnering with even IT and InfoSec and making sure that we're living up to their guidelines and serving their purposes as well. So it was collaboration all around on the entire end-to-end ecosystem.
And I would assume that, you know, even though you're trying to get rid of silos, not everybody is all in the same data lake or in the same database or data management system. How do you kind of help people with that as they look at, you know, they need data that's maybe not from their silo, it's from other silos?
Yeah, it's a balance. And on the data lifecycle, we try to keep things as standardized and consistent and raw as far as we can on the journey. So it does offer those opportunities to kind of drive things toward collaborating between different domains and making connections that would have never been possible before. So the consistent architecture really helps us achieve that, in that while we may be building against one source for one domain, it's going to be available up to a certain point to be molded into that fit for purpose data set that may come down the line in a completely different domain. And making sure that we take that into account through the modeling process and really build it in that modular fashion is how we set ourselves up for long-term success on that front.
Yeah, I love that. I think that makes a lot of sense. I think, again, this is why I was excited to have you on, because I think all the learnings that you've gone through in getting there, and I love the analogy, your first, I know it is literally your first, you know, the season is just getting underway for you. Having been to my first preseason game this past weekend, you know, I'm a big fan of your products, both online and in person, you know, and it's, again, you know, we'll see if the Patriots can pull anything out, but we'll, you know, we won't go there. It's, you know, that's that I think, again, you know, there's always hope at the beginning of the season, but I love that, you know, that's your cadence and how your business kind of rotates around that. I think one of the things, though, that was also interesting is you have these learnings that you had. Yeah. And, you know, what are some of those learnings that you want to impart on others about getting started on this journey? Because there, I think, especially with AI, people are looking at it and going, oh, we'll just bring it all together and we'll use all our data and AI, and, you know, we'll be all good to go and we'll AI it all. But, you know, people are trying to, I think more, thankfully, are taking a measured approach like you guys did. Mm-hmm. And they're just getting started on this journey. What do you think are some of the learnings for those people who are going down that similar journey? Because I don't think it's industry specific, what you guys are doing.
Yeah, no, you're right. And it's I think that the biggest learning was never underestimate the work. It takes so much to get to that point where you're anticipating the future and setting yourself up for success long term. It's a lot of work, not just hands on keyboard, but planning and thinking through different ways of engaging with stakeholders and delivering more effective products. But at the end of the day, it's worth it and almost necessary to modernize on this journey and set yourself up to change with the way the industry goes. I think that against that, one of the ways you do that is by just focusing on modularity. Like I said, the trends in the industry are going to change. If you asked us 2 years ago about some of the applications we support now, we couldn't have even thought them up, but the way we built in the modular fashion and making sure that we can scale and tackle needs on a use case basis, really build that toolbox and you can always kind of switch things in and out to support whatever's next. And I think the other thing that we are reminded of and continually appreciate more and more is you got to focus on the actual use cases and the stakeholders. You can build the most sophisticated and technologically exciting platform in the world, but it really doesn't matter unless your stakeholders are happy and able to serve up the insights they need or create the applications they need or really kind of drive the business to that next level. So that's always something that we try not to lose sight of.
Yeah, I totally agree with that as well, because I think especially when you get into AI and people are like, oh, well, what's the ROI of doing this AI project? And it's like, ah, we got all the way down through POC and then there was, you know, there was no ROI in it. It's like, well, you should probably figure that out ahead of time before you start doing all that effort down there. But yeah, I, you know, kind of bringing this to a close here, I think one of the things is I'm really interested in where do you see your strategy going in the future from a data platform perspective, especially as, you know, I know you guys push the boundaries with a lot of the applications and you're doing a lot of POCs all the time with your partners. And, you know, where do you see this going as we get more towards agentic applications that are going to be guaranteed to be joining the portfolio over the next, you know, couple of years here?
Yeah. At the end of the day, I think our goal is to stick to our core principles. And I think those are built around making sure that we stay relevant, that we stay capable of what's next. And any solution, I think, whether it's a BI report or a application directly interfacing with your data or an agentic application, it's all dependent on how well your data is organized and cataloged and how extensively you can use that from an access perspective and how confident you can be. So centering back on data quality and really the policies and tagging procedures so that as we do take it to the next level, we know that we're using our data safely and we know that we're using our data in compliant ways. It all centers back on that governance framework and making sure that we're confident in the data that we serve up to these services, even though we may not know right now what those services look like tomorrow.
Yeah, I think that is a great way to put it because again, you know, you guys have a lot of stakeholders that come to you from all over the place within you know, the league and everything. And I think it's again that I'm sure they're looking to see how you've been successful in this and try to replicate it out throughout the league. So, hey, really appreciate you coming on board, Joe. Thanks for sharing with us.
Yeah, thanks, Rob. It's been a pleasure.
And thank you for watching this episode of the Future of Data Platform Summit. We'll be back with more.